Okay, we continue with our chapter in section chapter 3. Okay, we are focusing now on oil price, elasticity, and total revenue. So we noted first about the concept of elastic, inelastic, and unitary. Okay, so in for elastic, that means increase in price lead to decrease in total revenue. Inelastic, increase in price lead to increase in total revenue. Okay. So increase in price lead to increase in total revenue. And unitary, total revenue is maximized at the point where demand is unitary elastic. So this concept will be well elaborated with our explanation in a graph here. Okay, you can see from here elasticity, total revenue, and linear demand. Okay, so just in case we will use the same graph here. We'll use the same graph, as you can see. Okay, we use price, quantity, okay, total revenue, and quantity, okay, and then in case, okay, we put a price in 80, say, so 80, and then our quantity is to produce and cancel, and we get 10. So that mean, okay, the total revenue, okay, we can see from here is 80 times 10, okay, equal to 800, right? That's total revenue. We want to see the total revenue and elasticity. Total revenue and elasticity. Okay, and continue if elasticity, total revenue, and linear demand. Linear means here, okay, linear demand. So just in case if we reduce the price, reduce the price from 80 to 60, okay, we can change the demand of quantity. Quantity of demand will be increased to 20. Okay, so we can get the result from here is 60 times 20, so equal to 12,000 total, our total revenue here. So it's of course much better. That means as a manager, we are looking for much better total or bigger total revenue. So as a manager, of course we will make a right decision whether we want to stay in $80 or $60. Of course, if we refer to the total revenue, okay, we will decide to reduce our price to 60, yeah, to get better revenue. And then if we decrease, we reduce our price cut to 40. Okay, what happened to 40? So if we cut a price to 40, that means you can see there are no different to total revenue, right? Okay, 40 times 30 equal to 1,200 total revenue. Okay, seem like we are rich in the situation that we have to look whether we want to produce, we want to reduce the price or not. And when we continue to cut the price to 20, Okay, you can see from 40 to 20. Okay, so our quantity of demand will increase until 40. Okay, so if calculate the total revenue, okay, will be here. Okay, sorry, 20 times 40. So that means 800. So the decision to reduce the price or cut the price to 20 is not smart. Okay, it's not the right move. Okay. And you can see from here, that's the relationship, that relationship between the elastic, inelastic, and unitary. Okay. So, in this situation, okay, this situation, you can see price is your price is elastic. Okay, okay, the quantity is elastic in this. Okay, and when you move, when you move or you change the price of quantity to the lower price, okay, it's become inelastic. Okay, become inelastic, and then we can see this is the point for maximum, the maximum point or unit elastic. That's the point of unit elastic. So as a manager, we are looking to, okay, to get, sorry, okay, we are looking to get this situation. To what we call as a profit maximization. Okay, that's the concept, what we call as a concept between elasticity, total revenue, and linear demand. Okay, I think it's very straightforward and simple. Okay, so for a linear inverse demand function, okay, marginal revenue quantity equal to A plus 2BQ, where B is lower than or smaller than 0, when marginal revenue is bigger than 0, demand is elastic. Okay, when marginal revenue equal to 0, so demand is unit elastic, and marginal revenue less than 0, demand is inelastic. Okay, so one of the principle that you have to remember, okay, if demand is elastic and increase in price will lead to decrease in total revenue. So if demand is inelastic and increase in price will lead to an increase in total revenue. So finally, total revenue is maximized at the point where demand is unitary elastic. That the principle that we want to explain here. Okay, so now that we you understand what the own price elasticity is and how it can be used to assess the impact of price changes on sales volume and revenues. So we will discuss three factors. We will discuss three factors that affect the magnitude of the own price elasticity of good. Okay, the first one you can see from here is available substitutes. Okay, and then time, and then expenditure share. So one key determinant of elasticity, one key determinant of elasticity of demand for a good is the number of close substitute. close substitute for that good. So intuitively, the more substitute available for the good, the more elastic the demand for it. In these circumstances, a price increase leads consumer to substitute toward another product, thus reducing considerably the quantity demanded of the good. So when there are few close substitute for a good, demand tends to be relatively inelastic. This is because consumer cannot readily switch to a close substitute when the price increases. Okay, that means the more substitute available to good, the more elastic. Okay, more substitute, more elastic demand. Okay, so a key implication of the fact or the effect of the number of close substitute on the elasticity of demand is that the key of a broadly defined commodities tends to be more inelastic than the demand for specific commodities. So for example, the demand for a good or broad commodity is more inelastic than the demand for beef. Short of starvation, there are no close substitute for food, and thus the quantity demanded for food is much less sensitive to price changes than is a particular type of food such as beef. So when the price of beef increase, consumer can substitute toward other type of food, including chicken, cow and fish. Thus the demand for beef is more elastic than the demand for food. Yeah, that's a simple example. Yeah. And then we can see for the second factor, time. Demand tend to be more inelastic in the short term than in the long run. So the more time consumer have to react to a price change, the more elastic the demand for the good. Conceptually, time allows the consumer to seek out available substitute. Okay, if you can see the example for smartphone as well, the more time for handphone or smartphone available in the market, so the more time and chance for consumer to seek for another substitute product. Before, maybe we just only focus on iPhone and BlackBerry before. Yeah, and now you can see a lot of choices. Okay. So demand tend to be more inelastic in the short term. Okay. So that's the concept. Then in the long term, so time allow consumer to seek available, okay, substitute. And then the last one that we want to see for the factor for own price elasticity is expenditure share. So goods that comprise a small share of consumer budget tend to be more inelastic than goods for which consumers spend a large portion of their income. So in the extreme case, where a consumer spend her or his entire budget on a good, the consumer must decrease consumption when the price rises. So in essence, there is nothing to give up but the good itself. So when a good comprises only a small portion of the budget, the consumer can reduce the consumption of goods when the price of the good increases. For example, more consumers spend very little on salt, and small increase in the price of salt would reduce quantity demanded. Very little, since salt constitute a small fraction of consumer total budget. Okay. So would you expect the own price elasticity of demand for good to be more or less elastic than that for transportation? So since food is a much greater necessity than transportation, after all, you cannot live without food. Yeah, right. So you might expect the demand for good to be more inelastic than the demand for transportation. Okay. Right, that's the explanation shared. Okay, I mean the simple word that we the portion of expenses that we will use in our expenditure. Okay. Okay, another important elasticity is cross price elasticity of demand. Okay, cross price elasticity of demand, which reveals the responsiveness of the demand for a good to changes in price of a related good. So this elasticity helps managers ascertain how much is demand will rise or fall due to change in the price of another firm's product. Okay. So the cross price elasticity of demand between goods X and Y, okay, we can use, okay, you denoted, okay, E, okay, elasticity of quantity X and Y, okay, goods X and Y, is mathematically we can use this as our equation. For instance, if the cross price elasticity of demand between Dell and Microsoft, maybe we can use between Open Office and Microsoft Word. Yeah. So word processing processor maybe is 3 and 10% high in the price of Word will increase the demand for Open Office for subscription by 30%, say, eh? So since 30%, okay, say okay, 10% hikes, okay, or increase, okay, in Microsoft Word, okay, will increase the Open Office, will increase the sale 30%, okay. Because of why? Okay, just simple like this. We use this, and then we can calculate 30%, okay, by 10% is equal to 3. Okay. So the cross price elasticity of demand between Microsoft Words and Open Office Word is 3. Okay, so this increase in demand for Open Office occurs because consumers substitute away from Word and towards Open Office due to the price increase. Okay, that's simple concept. Okay, that what we call as a cross price elasticity of demand. Cross price elasticity of demand.